Hello everyone, welcome back. In today's video, we'll discuss about the different problems related to our hair, the difference between hair loss and hair fall, how to treat and manage hair loss and hair fall, and also the questions related to oiling of hair, shampooing our hair. By the end of this video, I will tell you about a special Siddha hair tonic which can be used by everyone. It is very good for hair loss or hair fall, either conditions. It can also be used for dandruff, for different hair problems. It helps to improve the hair growth and also it prevents dandruff. So without wasting a single moment, we can start with the video. So hair loss and hair fall is two different things actually. So hair fall, first let's discuss about hair fall. Hair fall is actually caused due to a temporary stress factor. For example, right after delivery, many women must have experienced this. So when that stress factor goes away, the hair automatically resumes its volume. Similarly, if somebody has like doing fasting or dieting, if someone has undergone any surgery and suffering from blood loss or certain conditions, or sometimes if somebody has some viral fever, like for 20 days or 30 days they have been having some illness or viral fever, then also they may have this hair fall or hair shedding, which is often confused with hair loss. But you know, once the condition gets normal, then what happens, the hair automatically gets back to its original volume. But most of the time what happens is most of the people just go for different remedies and different solutions and get stressed, and overstressing and over getting more stress due to this hair fall. And if the stress factor remains for a long time, then it may be like a prolonged problem and it may lead to hair loss also. So hair loss is something, a condition in which the hair fails to regrow back. So the hair is shedding, but that particular area the hair fails to regrow, and you can see that the head is getting bald. So important factor is genetic factor, and we can see that in mostly in the males. So by 30 and 40 years the male starts, you know, the hairline gets receding and they start losing hair. So it's sort of factor which we get from our parents. The parents give it to their children, and actually most of the males you see when they reach about 50 or 60 years, their center of the head, you know, you can see that there is baldness. So that is what genetic factor is. And female, you cannot see a bald head, but you can see that their volume is reduced and their hair becomes very thin. So then the females who are using over chemicals and like artificial steamers and then dyes, then different hair products, so those are chemicals, and that they can also lead to hair loss. There are conditions like alopecia. Alopecia is an autoimmune condition in which our immune system attacks its own hair follicles. And what happens is that sometimes the head becomes completely bald. And females are also suffering from this problem. And I've seen cases in which the female loses all her hair. So it can be very easily treated. Actually, alopecia is not a incurable or untreated condition. It can be treated well if treated in right time. So then there are also other conditions. For example, if there is a hormonal problem, like for example thyroid problem, or there is PCOD during menopause, or any metabolic conditions like diabetes, then also you can see hair loss. So during hair fall and hair loss, what the common mistake a person make is that they keep applying different hair oils and different things on their hair, like you know, some make this egg white, and some apply different sort of herbal oil, some use different types of hair packs. So what happens during this is that when we apply and we keep rubbing our scalp, due to friction, you know, it leads to more hair loss. So actually if you're suffering from a severe hair fall or hair loss condition, you should definitely consult a doctor, and he or she will guide you with the right method, how you can care and how you can regain your hair back. Now let's discuss about oiling of hair. So our Indian market has so many different types of herbal oils, Ayurvedic oils, then you have different types of international brand oils, fragrant oils. Some people mix all the oils and they use on their head. So what are the things one should keep in mind when they're oiling their hair? So basically, if you look into in Kerala, there is a habit of oiling the hair every day. And some people, like in when you go towards north, there's not much frequent oiling of hair. People oil once or twice a week, or they oil like once a week, or some people don't oil their hair also. So how often should you hair your oil, hair oil your hair. So normally we all must be having an oil which we are using in our family, like all the family generations we are using. And whether it is any oil, make sure it should be cold pressed oil. Cold pressed means which is not treated with heat or which is not treated with chemicals. It is just done by mechanical process, and it is very safe to use. So basically I would recommend coconut oil, because in South India it's very easily available. If you're living in some other places, you can use some oil which is local and which is easily available as cold pressed oil of your area. And if you've been already using an oil, you can use that also. Some people also make oil at home, mix oil at home. If that is helping you, no problem. But how often you should oil the hair? Better you should like at least twice or thrice a week you should oil. You can gently massage your the oil with your fingers, and you can also gently heat the oil. Heating the oil doesn't mean that directly like exposing the oil to the flame. You can just take a bowl of hot water and place the oil in a container above that water, and it is called double boiling method. And by that, the oil will slightly get heated up, warmed up, and that oil you can apply on your hair. It will help to nourish your scalp, it will help to improve the blood flow, and also it will help to regain the volume. But if you're suffering from hair fall or hair loss, better you will apply with some cotton wool, because directly applying with fingers and rubbing can, as I said, can lead to more hair loss. And then second thing, never leave the oil for a long time in your hair. Like some people have a habit of like leaving hair on the, in the hair overnight. Like they keep the hair, like they oil the hair at night, and they again in the morning they wash their hair. Actually this practice is not very good, because what we recommend is like you should apply and you should like 2 or 3 hours maximum you should keep the oil on the hair, and then go for a hair cleaning. Hair cleaning should be a very important part of your hair regimen. Most of the people skip that. Some people don't, just keep oiling their hair, which will accumulate dust and which will accumulate dandruff. Sometimes that may lead to itchy scalp also. So make sure you use the right product to shampoo your hair. So now, how can you use the right product to shampoo your hair? So market is again fully flooded with like different shampoos and different sort of conditioner. So what we recommend is go for a very mild shampoos. If you are using hair regularly, hair oil, and you're regularly washing your hair, make sure the shampoo is very mild. So how can you know the shampoo is mild? So go for SLS and paraben free shampoos, first thing. Second thing, you should go for transparent ones. So transparent ones means when you pour the shampoo in your hands, that should be transparent. You can see through that shampoo, that product. So that means the oil, that shampoo is not very harsh, and it will not lather much, because those products which are more having more parabens and SLS or sulfates are lather, and they are more mixed with chemicals. The opaque ones, the colored ones, all are mixed with chemicals. So basically go for transparent shampoos. And if your hair and scalp is very sensitive, I would recommend some mild baby shampoo. So when you take baby shampoo, it is just like tears, you know, it's very very transparent and you can see through it, and it's very mild also. So basically that will be better. And then if you don't want to go for any sort of artificial product, you can also make your own shampoo at home. So basically you can make your own herbal shampoo at home. For this you need soap nut or Rita. And what you have to do is you have to soak this Rita overnight. You can take 1 cup of Rita, and with 2 cups of water you can soak it overnight, and next day morning you can just boil this mixture and reduce it to 1 cup. Filter that, let it cool, and then apply on your hair. It lathers it very well, and it cleanses your scalp very well. Also you can add a little bit of shikakai or dried amla. That also you can get online, and you can add to this mixture like some few pots of shikakai and dried amla if you need more bounce and shine to your hair. This method can cleanse your scalp very good, and if you have any dandruff problem, that will also go. And it is very mild, and it doesn't have any sort of chemicals or preservatives. So if your hair is very dry, so you can again use some hibiscus leaf, and you can use hibiscus flowers. Both you can take, you can crush in water, and you can add some more water. You can filter this mixture, and you can again use in your scalp. That is also a very good cleanser which you can use at home. So these two are basically very safe and easy to use at home. Then in Siddha there is a preparation which is very very healthy and very very safe, and everybody can use it. You can also see this product in most of the Siddha shops. It's called Panjkalpa Kuliyal Churnam. It contains of 5 herbs, five herbs which are kalpa herbs, and it helps to nourish the scalp, it stimulates hair growth, it removes dandruff, and it also improves it stimulates the hair follicles, and it also prevents diseases as per Siddha. So it is a complete hair tonic, and I have also tried it in alopecia patients. I have tried it in patients who are suffering from dandruff. I have tried it in patients who are suffering from psoriasis, and it is an excellent medicine for everybody, I have found. And what you have to do is, you have to take this powder. This is a blend of five herbs. As I said, it is a mixture of amla or nelikai. It has pepper, it has kasturi manjal, it has neem or Azadirachta directa indica, which you call neem. It has kadukai or Terminalia cebula. So these are the five herbs, and these five herbs denote the panchabhutas, all these five herbs. And this is actually a balance of these five herbs. A mixture of these five herbs is excellent for your body, and also we have asked a patient to apply on their body if they are suffering from any skin ailments. So not only scalp, because the scalp is a continuation of your skin itself, so it can be applied on the body also. And it is an excellent medicine for overall health. It restores your general health also. So what you have to do is just take this powder and make a paste with the help of cow's milk. And you have to boil this mixture till the bubbles arrive. After that, you have to just switch off the stove, let it cool, apply on your scalp, leave it there for 30 minutes or 1 hour, and then wash it off with cool water. This is a very simple step. People, the ladies who have delivered, they can also use it. It's very good, and it will never if you're using it regularly, you'll feel that your hair becomes more stronger and healthier also. So this is a very good medicine for people who are suffering from frizzy hair, unmanageable hair, and people who are suffering from any breakage. The hair grows and they fails to regrow in the proper length, and they break. Most of the people complain of split ends. So all these problems can be cured from one medicine, and that can be used by everybody, and it is very easy. And now it's available online also. You can get it online, no problem. So this is what Siddha says. And if you're going for any oil, if you want to apply some oil on your hair, make sure that if you're applying oil for some particular condition, if you have dandruff or you have some hair loss problem or hair fall problem, make sure you ask your doctor, and then only you apply that particular oil on your hair. Because if you're looking for dandruff part, we have different oils which are helpful in controlling dandruff. There's Pududalai Thailam, there is Wet Palai Thailam. If you're looking for hair shedding, there are different types of oils. If you're having some other conditions, if you're having a problem that is connected to your internal factors, if you're having problem due to some metabolic problem or due to some deficiency disease, external application will not help. So first find the right cause of your hair fall and then get treated, and you'll definitely see that you'll have results. Okay, so that's all for today. So if you like this video, follow us on YouTube and Facebook, and keep supporting us. Thank you for watching.